Hey, good morning, everyone. I was having trouble connecting, but welcome, welcome, welcome. Need to do a sound check before we do anything else. How is my sound? Not sure if we're even live because it's getting a little crazy. Somebody's making a comment. Chris Castelli. Hey, Chris. Good morning, Chris. Chris, how is my sound? Can you hear me okay? Scarlett and Paisley say, hey, hey, to Chris and Miley. We are coloring today from Color Alone Volume 17 once again, and we're coloring in the bolding technique today. So let me just get some things set up here. So that we know what we're doing today. Of course, get the draw the bone. Chris is telling me that the sound is good. G-double-O-D. Sharon is saying sound is good too. Okay, of course, let me take care of my friends, Scarlett and Paisley. Good morning to Alice. Good morning. Let's wait for everyone else to get here. I'm using Duet Color Swap and markers. Hang on a second. Now, gonna get some dog biscuits set up. Sound is good. Okay, cool. Sound is good. Miss Collett, Miss Paisley. Okay, so we are coloring a page from Column 1, Volume 17. We are working on the bolding technique today. And I'm using some markers, and I'm using Duet ColorSoft pencils. So, first of all, let's get this shared out to the rest of the universe. And, I don't know, let's have some fun for an hour of escape, right? Let's see if I can get this pasted. Okay, that is there. Oh, Chris is back. Awesome. So what's new, everyone? Winter day today, right? What's happening, Alice? Haven't talked to you in a while. I had a crazy week, you know? Had a crazy, weird things. Just weird stuff. How about all of you? Weird things happen, you know? Scarlett and Paisley, these are your last ones. Now go lay down and take a break. Don't laugh at that, right? Because it really is the last one. All right, I'm just going to get this shared out to a couple other places, if you don't mind. And, let me see here. Had some trouble connecting today onto YouTube. I don't know why. I think it was me. I'm going to blame myself. I'm not even going to blame technology today. I'm just going to blame it on my brain, you know? Blame it on me for what's happening. Then it was a different way. Oh my goodness, I don't even know. All right. So we only have a few more weeks left of this Color Along book. And then we're moving on to Color Along Volume Teen. Do you know about Volume Teen? Right, Scarlett? Scarlett's saying, what are you talking about? Volume 18 is what we're moving on to. I believe begins in March. I need to order a copy of that for myself. Alice says, it's crazy times when you are trying to move. Pain is unreal in sickness. Oh, Alice, I wish I could just get in my car and come over and help you. And actually, just kind of, it's one degrees. It's not that cold out here today, but we're about to get a storm tomorrow. So let me tell you what the temperature is here today. The temperature here is 40 degrees. It says it's like 34, but we're under a winter storm warning. So I believe that I have a standing, appointment with my friend Sharon tomorrow? Are we still doing that, Sharon? You know, we're going to walk the mandala in the snow. I don't really think I can do it. I'm visiting a lot of pain myself, too, Alice, so I don't think I'm going to be doing that. All right, let's see. Where are we? All right, so today's page is the bowling technique. This can also be found in Springtime Whimsy. Oh, my goodness, Scarlet. What is the problem, honey? All right, let me see if I can get her something else to keep her quiet. Come on. Come on, because no one wants to hear her speak. Dogs are very unruly, aren't they? Drive me crazy sometimes. Please, the dreaded S is coming and I am not ready for it all. Alice got a dusting of snow last night. Yeah, we're supposed to, I don't even know how much we're supposed to get, but somebody needs to come over to my house and shovel. Because I can't shovel this year, so I want to, but I'm thinking maybe, hey Dawn, hey Lynn, I'm thinking maybe I should build a snowman. Should we build a snowman this year or what? All right, let's see. We've got bolding. Let's get on to serious business here. Bolding is all about making the outline 48 inches. Oh, my goodness. That's a lot of snow. I asked somebody, all right, I'm going to start with this. I'm going to outline the edge with this purple. Then I'm going to color the inside of the house with purple. Okay? So let's see if we have purple in here. I don't even know if we do. Well, this is purple enough for me. It is called Deep Fuchsia. Let me just give it a quick shopping. I asked somebody today how much snow we're getting. And they said, not a lot. What does that mean? And then they said, about 6 inches. I said, that's a lot. That's a lot. That means you have to shovel it. I always look at the forecast for the following day to see if it's worth my time to shovel, right? And then if it's going to melt, why am I bothering? So, you know, sometimes it's we have a storm and then the next day it's like 50 degrees, 60 degrees, well, 50. Even 50 degrees would melt it. I don't make a big deal about that. I'll tell you, though, people think that shoveling now is just like, I don't know. I think the people that shovel definitely charge way too much money. I know it's a lot of work, and I know it's back-breaking, and it's heavy, and I know all that, but, I mean, come on. What happened to the kid that used to come over and shovel for 10 bucks, right? Sharon, who is ever ready for S? Alice is saying, not me. Just hope when I do the big stuff there is no snow or rain because I can't move it then. Oh, Alice, I hope that it goes well for you. All right, so there is my interior, my inside part of the house, and then I've bolded that section there, but I am going to use a heavier pressure with this pencil here, and then there we go, just kind of move on like that. Does that make sense? So I'm just going to keep moving along, and for those of you that are here watching but can't comment, I know that Mamie Hickstead watches a lot, and she's not able to comment most of the time. So, big shout out to Mamie. So, any of you that are watching that cannot comment on these YouTube videos, thank you for watching and being quiet in the background. But for those of you that participate and add to the chatter, of course, that's always fun too, right? So, that's brown. And then I'm going to take a little bit of deep or dark terracotta. Hey, good morning, Bonnie Hughes. You know, by the way, I've been tagging people on Facebook to get ready for these color alongs. And I can't tag everybody. You want to know why? Because Facebook tells me to slow down. So if I have not tagged you in the Facebook post, my apologies. Don't take it personally. It's just that I had to, like, do them quick, and then stop. You know? Quick, and then stop. So that's what happened with that. Yeah, it does make that door pop, doesn't it? I'm actually going to give it a yellow door with just marker, Alice. I really want it to be like, you know, pop, like a yellow door. You know, I thought about painting the front door of my house yellow. It's like a dark blue right now. And my house is beige, so I thought to myself when I was originally thinking of this, you know, how crazy would that be to paint it yellow against a beige house? And then I rode by a house that same very day. There's the Spidey sense, right, Sharon? That very same day, and all of a sudden, I saw a beige house with a yellow door. So you got to think about it, and it happens, right? Had a couple other crazy things happen the past week like that, you know? All right, now, is anybody home in this house? Do we know if anybody's home? You know, the lights are on and no one's home. You know you're singing it, right? Dawn says, I finally hired someone to plow the driveways at both houses, and I just can't do it, even though we have snow blowers. You know, I think snow blowers are a lot of work, to be honest. I mean, you still got to push it. You're still going to be out there in the freezing cold temperatures. And the snow blowing, you still need to shovel something. My friend Scarlett needs to come over here. Come over here, Scarlett. Come here. Come here, baby. Come here. Sit down, honey. Come on. Sit down. Lay down, please. Okay? Come on. You can participate with us, but just lay down. Okay? Go ahead. Lay down. Good job, Scarlett. She laid down. The other day, I was doing a video class, and she was crying and crying and crying, and I said to her, you know what, why don't you go over to the window and see if FedEx is here delivering your bones? And she got up, and she trotted over to the window and sat there and waited. It was funny. Thank God for our snowblower, Sharon, saying you really don't have to push it. It is self-propelled once you engage the handle. Well, come on over. You are hired. It's still heavy, though. Yes, see? It's still heavy. I have an electric snowblower. I hate it. It's in my backyard. It's not even in a safe place. I don't even treat it nice. No, I just really don't like it. It just really, I don't know. It just really bugs me. It's hard to push it. Especially the electric ones. The electric ones you have to really push. It's not self-propelled. But you're still out there in the elements, you know? You're still out there. It's not like you're out there in a nice... And you still have to get, like, the corners of stuff, and it's just... It just ain't right, is what I say. Okay, so here's some red. And now I am going to put some a line, even though it's on the other side of that, the other side of that house, and here, too, because I just kind of want to make that bold line. And let's do this one like that, too, a little bit differently. And then what I'll do is for the windows, I'll go back in and do something else. And that kind of got a little gibberish over there. I'm just going to color this with red here. You know, I actually think I am getting a delivery right now. All right, so this is just this red color. Now look at the difference when you actually add a little bit. I'm actually gonna put something underneath this because I want to raise it up. So let's raise it up a little bit. And let's see if we can add a better light. Light, there we go. Is that better? I think that's better. Let me get something else to raise it up too. I want to go up even more. Hang on a second. I think that's better, right? Let's see if I can slip something underneath there. All right. Oh, much better. Yeah, so snowblowers are heavy. I mean, let's face it, right? But I don't know. It's going to happen. you live where you live and you gotta just kind of deal with it. But spring is on the way. We're counting down the days till spring. It's already starting to get light out. Did you notice that? It's not as dark so late. All right, so there's that green there. And I think I'm gonna do the same thing with this. I don't really want it to look Christmassy. So here's some green there. Now, what else do we have? We've got that front door, right? So what color should we make a front door that's on a red house? I noticed it stays lighter longer too, Dawn, right? Like last night it was like 4:35, and I'm gonna color this house with this purple color, this like lavender color. Last night it was like 4:35 when I happened to look out the window, and it wasn't dark out. And a few weeks ago it was dark at that time. Remember when it was dark then? I'm still gonna go with this fuchsia color here that's similar to this, but I'm gonna kind of go on its side so it's a little lighter. And I'm going to mix this with white, because once I mix it with white, it will definitely make it creamier. I'll tell you one thing, the dogs know it's going to snow, because listen to them. My dogs are driving me crazy today. Now I need to go see what the heck is going on out there. Pencils have a hard time in this sharpener because of the thickness of them. Does anybody else have Duet colored pencils? The thickness of the pencil is much thicker than normal. I've got to go get my dogs to stop barking. It's really bugging me. I hope it's not bugging you as much as it's bugging me. But so it's a frustrating thing when I'm trying to pay attention. The purple houses need the lights on. Well, I'm going to start singing Robert Plant song, right? Okay, I'm about to say all dogs go lay down. That's what my next sentence is about to be. Oh my goodness! What did you buy for a pencil sharpener, Dawn? Dawn says she bought a pencil sharpener to accommodate a bigger pencil. What type of pencil sharpener did you buy? Can you share it with us? Because I love this Bostitch pencil sharpener, but I don't like it when it comes to a Duet product. So. I want something that will make it so that it will adjust. Did you buy one that will adjust to different pencils? So the lights are on in this house. No one's home, though. Or maybe somebody is home if I put two little black eyeballs. I think I'm going to. Someone's peeking out the window. It must be someone from that, you know, top bedroom. And then this door, I think I'm going to go with... I'm going to go with an orange door on this one. Gonna go with an orange door on this one and color this with some orange here. Now you could also go over the lines for these with a colored pencil rather than a marker, but I always kind of like to mix it up a little bit. This color is finally laid down, thank God. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm gonna give this one a black door now too. Now, It's an electric one, brand name Amont, off of Amazon. And yes, it fits different sizes. Oh, I'll have to look for that. Thank you, Dawn. Thank you for sharing that, Dawn. All right, so the next house, I think we need something that's blue, don't you? Blue, blue, blue. We're going to go with this one. I'm still not decided on that door. Open to suggestions. But I am going to add that line, like, around the other side of it. I do kind of like how that looks. I don't usually do that, but... And then here's another line here. And these markers that I'm using are Faber-Castell Duo Tips. I'm using my two favorite brands today, Faber-Castell and Durant. Hey, Sherry. Make that Afmat as the brand name. I'm probably not even saying it correctly. Oh, Sharon says I bought an AFMAT. I'm just going to spell it. Rechargeable electric pencil sharpener. Specifically for the larger charcoal and duet pencils, it has an adjustable shaft that sharpens up to 6 to 12 millimeters. I bet you never, ever imagined that you would ever be writing those words somewhere saying that something had an adjustable shaft that sharpens up to 6 to 12 millimeters. If anybody has the link to that and you could pop it into the Just Color Coloring group on Facebook, it would be great. Popping it into this chat may not be a good idea. Right, Sharon? Just like, I mean, did you ever imagine that we would be talking about a shaft that's adjustable? I mean, come on. You got to admit, a live video, it always has conversation in it that you just think to yourself, what the heck? I'm just going to kind of go around this tree. And then I'm also going to go around that tree again with some green, because that's a green tree there. So we just kind of, and I'm going to go around this one also. Sharon. Oh, I don't know. Sharon needs to be my co-host someday on one of these live videos. Or somebody does to chat along with me. Have a good laugh. I don't know, though. Some of the stories or some of the conversations you could have with some people would be like, I'm not sure if we should be talking about that. You know, you gotta, like, be PG. PG. Is anything PG anymore, though? Think about it. Doesn't seem like it is. I think I'm going to go with the brown door on this one, by the way. I've been thinking about it. Kind of looks good with the red. I'm sorry my dogs are a pain in the neck today, by the way. I don't know who this next person is that's making a comment, but hello. Okay, so... Here's this section here. That's the brown. Now, what color do we need to have some yellow? I think all the lights should be on, right? Everybody. Not suitable for all. I don't even think it's suitable for my age. You know? I don't even think it's suitable. What other book is that picture in? Marianne, this is in Springtime Whimsy. And I looked for it this morning in this cabinet where I keep all my books. And I gotta tell you. I was losing energy to even get into the cabinet because I needed to move something to get into the cabinet. Yes, I needed to move a piece of furniture to get into it. To really, like, get into... What I really need to do is empty the cabinet completely and really, like, dive deep into it. You know? Dive deep into it. There's another thing you might not have thought you were going to say. This is called Dark Brown. And... I'm just going to kind of do a heavy pressure, but look, it's almost the same color as this. You know, I saw this painting video the other day, and I think that we need to try it in our painting, in the painting classes, for those of you that are part of my painting classes. You know, they took, we could do it with coloring too, I guess, but it was a photograph of a pickle. I know, weird. Hey, Dawn. It was a photograph of a pickle, and the pickle was... I lost my pencil for a second. Nope. Nope. I didn't. Okay, here we go. This is the one I was looking for. The gray one, right here. All right. It was a photograph of a pickle. So, for example, I'll draw it on the back of this. Here was the piece of the thing, right? And here was the pickle. Just a dill pickle sliced in half, apparently. And, oh, thank you, Chris. I appreciate you saying that. They drive me crazy a little bit. Because I get very, very, it frustrates me because I'm always getting up and down with them. Apparently, they think that when everything starts, it's a party. And, you know, gotta go outside. I'm not gonna deprive a dog from going outside, that's for sure. I don't know what kind it was, Sharon. I guess it was dill. A dill pickle spare, I guess, right? Sliced in half. Anyway, it was a picture of a pickle. So it was green. Then, next to it, the person was mixing the paint in order to get it to match, blend completely. So whatever was being mixed over here was blending completely with that pickle. So the goal was to be able to create that pickle color. I don't want to say green, but the goal was to create the pickle color with paint. What do you think? Do we need to do it? I don't think we need to do it with the pickle, but we should probably do it with something else. And then you place your color that you mixed next to the pickle. It was a picture of a pickle, not a real pickle. But they placed it next to the pickle, and the pickle, yes, create green. It is your favorite thing. Sharon hates the color green. So we do this painting class every Saturday, or every other Saturday, or the Monday classes, which anybody is welcome to join, by the way. We have a lot of fun. And anyway, Sharon hates green. Sharon, Dawn is saying, the one that I bought is no longer available, or at least that model. They have others that shop in 6 to 12 millimeter. Wow, 12? Is that what Sharon said, too? Was 12? How many millimeters is an average pencil? Sounds like a personal question, doesn't it? Does sound like a personal question. All right, so I'm just kind of going on the side here for this because I don't want it to be scratchy. But I want it to be kind of creamy, and even though that's gray, it doesn't really look like gray, but I am going to take a little bit of this white, and you don't hate it? Okay, don't like having to create it. Ooh, okay, big difference, right? Good thing you're not in charge of... a good thing you're not in charge of the grass, right? A good thing you are not Mother Nature. I don't even know if I can say that with a straight face or without laughing. Do you laugh so hard every day that, I mean, at least once a day, you gotta at least laugh so that you can just kind of like, you know, crack up. Hey, you know, everybody's been commenting about that poem that I posted, that I shared, called Let Yourself Rest. And what do you think about that poem? Marianne and Dawn both made a comment. I know that. I'm sure other people did too. But I know Marianne made a comment and shared it with several different people. And it basically is telling people to say, you know, you don't have to be busy all the time. You don't have to be productive. I think it's all about being productive, right? So I think that one of the things that it's talking about is not being productive all the time. You don't have to, maybe busy is not even the word. Do you think it is? What do you think, Marianne? How about you, Dawn? I know you made a comment that you have a hard time doing that. I have a hard time doing that too, because sometimes what's restful to me maybe something that other people think of as being busy and not resting. But like coloring something or painting something or drawing something or... Do you have to just sit and do literally nothing, or is there what is the definition of doing literally nothing? I used to have a friend that this is going back like, oh my goodness, maybe 30 years, right? And because, well, how could that be? Because I'm only 35, so I must have been 5. Okay, so back when I was 5, I know that's not even funny. Okay, I'll take that back. Anywho, this friend used to say that, do you have plans? If you would say to him, I mean, not all the time, but he said it a couple of times. Do you have any plans tonight? Yes, I do. I have plans tonight. I have plans doing nothing. Those were his plans. In other words, that's my plan. My plan is to do nothing. I don't want to be bothered. I don't want to talk to anybody. I want to do my own version of nothing. Maybe our own version of nothing is to sit outside, listen to the birds. Paisley's version. And I'm going to tell you, if you want to do nothing and really sit and, like, have a restful day, I would follow my dog Paisley around for the day and just do whatever she does, because she's probably one of the most... She really takes advantage of her quiet and resting, let me tell you. But, you know, you can learn a lot from a dog or from a cat or any type of pet about what they teach you. Paisley pretty much has taught me to just sit. Just sit and just be. So what do you think? Do you think that it's possible to do that? Or do you think it's all just a bunch of, you know, hoopla? I'm going to make this... The middle, this roof, it's some orange. Well, I think about that. Sharon's saying, I saw it and I loved it. It gives you license to not feeling responsible for doing something or being something all the time. Right, but what is your idea of relaxing? I mean, can you, like Marianne told me that, some made a comment about dishes in the sink. Well, that bothers me. So I don't know if I can relax and do nothing unless that's clean. You know, so... That makes me feel relaxed. So I don't know. What do you think? I guess you could just sit there and do and literally just sit. Some people are have to have a hard time sitting and doing nothing and being alone with their thoughts, right? I'm just going to color this one lightly so we can really... See that purple that's around the roof here. Okay, so there is that purple color. I'm going to leave that the way it is. Now this house back here, I feel like that house really needs to kind of be like a good color to pop. And I feel like it could be this mint, this green color. So let's go with a dark green for our bolding right here. Even though it's kind of like the same color as that tree, and I'm going to put bold some a marker here, some here on this side of it, here, here. Sharon is, a 9mm, if I remember correctly, Dawn is saying about just the average size colored pencils. You know what, though? Does that have to do with the lead? Does that have to do with the lead, Dawn? Or does that have to do with the actual barrel of the pencil? That's the lead, right? Yeah, that's the lead. I'm answering my own question. Do you ever do that? You ask a question and then you answer it? I'm turning into my mother. Okay, Sharon says, my idea of relaxing is not having anything on my agenda for the day. No responsibilities to anyone or anything, just doing exactly what I feel like doing at any given moment of the day. Well, yeah, but how about even just to yourself, right? You do need free days like that. Sometimes I just feel like, yeah, I agree with you. No responsibility. Nothing that you have to do. Like, you can just spend a day and just do whatever you feel like doing. You feel like sitting, you sit. You feel like not washing clothes, you just don't. Right? Okay, I'm going to go with this kind of like purplish color for the outline of this window here. Alice says, I took Cleo over to the apartment yesterday and she meowed for 2 hours. Oh, that would drive me nuts too. I've been taking her over there once a week to get used to the apartment, but I don't know if she will ever get used to it. Oh no. Well, what did she do when she went there? What did you guys do? I wanted to pull my hair out. Yeah, those days are few and far between. I hear you, Sharon. There's always, like, so much that has to happen, right? But tomorrow, what can you do? Not much. It's going to snow. All right, color is my roof going to be? Let's make it brown. Get all those pens out of my hand. I guess busy is not the right word, Dawn says. I guess productive would be better. I have to get beyond thinking that I need to finish or accomplish something. Yeah, I agree with you. I wouldn't mind having a day or a several of them where there's things that I just am not responsible for. You know? Like, I don't know. It's not even just productive. It's just a matter of... I don't feel that I have to be busy all the time. I just feel like maybe I need to just kind of let, like, certain things go. Like, for example, my trash got picked up yesterday, and I'm telling you, maybe, like, I don't know, maybe this is TMI. Anywho, my trash cans got picked up yesterday, and the trash cans should have been brought in last night, but did I do it? No, because it was raining out, and it was freezing, and it was cold, and I didn't feel like going out there in the rain, in the dark, by the time I guess I had a chance to do it. Maybe I kept putting it off, thinking I'll just do it, and then all of a sudden it was dark. So, stuff like that. I guess I just feel like, you know, I used to worry and keep thinking about those trash cans. But I really haven't given them a second thought. I do wonder what my neighbors are thinking. Are they thinking that, wow, they haven't taken in their trash all that time? You know? Would you think that about your neighbors? I mean, I guess if my trash was blowing down the street, I would probably make a comment, but who knows? Hey, Bonnie Miller! Dawn says, if I follow my dogs, I would be sleeping all day. Maybe we should have days where we just do that, right? Just follow the dogs, sleep all day. Now, do you think that the bolding line should be darker than the inside section that gets colored, or do you think it should be opposite? I've been doing it, I guess, darker, right? But on this one, I'm doing the inside a little bit darker than the line that I created on the outside to make that bolding look. And then I'll put some, I don't know what happened to my yellow colored pencil. There it is. For my window. All the lights are on in this neighborhood. They are awake and they're ready for the night. Alice says, I unpacked stuff and she walked around meowing. Maybe it was a happy kind of meow. Do you think it was more of like a, I hate this kind of hate this place meow? Or was it, do you think it was a, this is so exciting meow? Maybe she needs another cat friend. That would be interesting, right? Sharon says, my hubby looks at everyone's barrels in the neighborhood and thinks it's just terrible that they are not taken in on the day of pickup. Well, there could be many reasons, you tell him, why the trash can may not be taken in. Technically, you're not supposed to leave them out there in the city. You can get a fine. But try to take my money. Try to fine me. There may be many reasons. Maybe the person's sick. Maybe they didn't feel good. Maybe they didn't feel like it. Maybe they were busy. Maybe they just, I don't know, had other things to do. Oh, I would hate that. Bonnie saying that she does not have trash pickup in her neighborhood. You have to take it to the dump. I know, I would not like that. I know a few people that have to do that. I don't like it. All right, we need something else, another color house back there. I'm thinking it could be another, maybe orange house. The actual house could be orange. So let's outline it with some orange. Oh, no, we can't because of this roof. How can I not know what color to make it out of all the colors that are in the world, right? We could make it a peach color. Actually, let's make it brown. We don't have a brown house in here, right? I'm going to outline it with brown. Alice says, I guess it depends on what you want in the picture to pop. The house you are doing The house you're doing, the windows pop. Yeah, I think the house, the windows should pop like that, right? And I am going to kind of go around that window a little bit with this brown. And then go with dark brown right here. Sharon says, I don't even entertain his comments with conversation. When it comes to the barrel, it's not a concern of mine, and I really don't understand why it is for him. I mean, again, maybe it bugs him. Does he ever go get the barrels and put them in the driveway for them? I used to have a neighbor that did that with recycle bins. He would, like, not the barrel, but like a bin. Remember the square recycle bins? We don't have those here, but I guess a lot of people still have them. Anyway, this guy used to take my recycle bins if I didn't bring them in fast enough. And he used to put them one inside the other. Now, granted, it was kind, right? It was a kind gesture for him to do. Fine. Let me give this a red roof. But the barrels always got stuck together. And I always had a hard time getting them apart. And that part used to drive me nuts. You know? That part really used to bug me. That he did that. I mean, so it's like, you gotta wonder, Sharon, is it a kind gesture or is it like, or it's like the time that I had someone set up to shovel my driveway, and then my neighbor, out of the, I guess he thought he was being helpful, decided to shovel only half my driveway. So from the street, you could only see like a portion of my driveway shovel. It looked like it was completely shoveled. So the guy that was supposed to come over and shovel came by, looked at it, and said, huh, she had someone else do it, and left. And then I was stuck with the rest of my driveway not being shoveled, and I couldn't get anybody to shovel it. So you got to kind of think to yourself, yeah, it's nice that they did that, but maybe you're kind of like, I don't know, raining on their parade, right? All right, now this part right here, I'm going to bold it in blue over here too, and then I'm going to do some blue, a blue background for this one. I do have to give this a quick sharpen, though, so hang on a second. Let me move my bostage. Oh, Alice is talking about her cat, Cleo, still. She says, I think she is scared because it takes her a while to even come out of the carriage, so I'm trying to get used to the apartment. Oh. Well, maybe. I hope it doesn't take long for her to get used to it, right? She probably is afraid. She's probably saying, what is going on? I can't imagine how my dogs would do. I think that Scarlet would bark a lot. I always think to myself about, like, going over to see. They never go over to anybody else's house, but I always wonder, what would they ever do if they went over to somebody's house? They would probably just, like, ransack the whole place. I cannot imagine what they would do. Does anybody else's dogs go over to people's house? Bye, Bonnie. Thanks for stopping in. Sharon says, yes, I think it's a kind gesture. Hubby thinks there's maybe an issue where they can't bring them in and he does it for them. Well, I hope they appreciate it. That's very nice of him. Or maybe they're saying in the house, there goes that guy again, wheeling my barrels in. No, I'm only kidding. I can get my cans as soon as possible because the garbage man throws the cans and they will end up in a ditch if I don't get them, Alice is saying. Yeah, sometimes mine will get blown away, but so I guess that's the next thing I'm doing after I'm done with this. The cans sit outside, right? What a crazy conversation. You got to admit, it is a little nuts. All right, so now I'm going to add some different colors. Sharon says, we had a cat when I was younger that hid in a closet for a week when we moved into another home. I can imagine. Okay. Tell your husband that I want the cans, the trash cans, in a particular place. I don't want them to be put in us on one section of the driveway, though, Sharon, so you're going to have to make sure that you give him clear instructions, you know? I expect them to be a certain way. No, I'm only kidding. That would be awful. Not over there. All right, so this is just kind of like that purplish color. Oh my goodness, I didn't realize this page was going to take me so long to color, but my goodness, it has. All right, let's add some, I guess some purple. I was going to kind of like shake it up with the purples, but let's move on to maybe orange. We'll add orange here. And orange pencil. Oh, Chris is giving some insight about the cat. Miley meowed a lot for the first week that I lived in this apartment, and then she just settled in. So I guess it's a normal thing, right? To all of our cat lovers. Dawn says, the dumps near us will not let you in if you are either outside the city or a village, so we have to have trash pickup now. If my husband were here, he would be having a fit. Because of the trash pickup? I wouldn't want to have to load my trash into my car and bring it to the dump. I mean, I just wouldn't. At all. I know a few people that do that. But can you pay for private pickup? I bet you could. I mean, I know that one person that I know that does that. You can pay for a private pickup. Like, you can pay for trash pickup. There's actually a house on my street that pays to have their trash picked up. And you can get it picked up by the city for free. Isn't that weird? It makes me wonder, what are they throwing away? Like, why would you have to pay for something that you're already paying for in your taxes? It's very strange. They have a separate truck that comes. It's very odd to me. I just wondered sometimes, exactly what are you throwing away? And they always put their trash out on the same day, too. So that's even weirder. Very strange. Sharon says, well, we all know how following instruction goes for the male of the species. Do you think? Well, you told me the other day that they need to be trained, right? That's what your advice was the other day, or your words of wisdom. I don't remember what we were talking about, but you did say they have to be trained, all of them. You have to pay for trash pickup, Alice? Yeah, so, I mean, if you had the option, right, then I would pay for it rather than having to go to the dump. Just one less thing to do. You know? All right, now I'm going to go with some green for the grass on the bottom. Alice says, what would Paisley and Scarlett think if you told them to fetch the cans? They would look at me like, actually, Scarlett hates the trash cans, by the way. That's the other thing, is that Scarlett hates them because they have these plastic wheels on them. And she cannot stand the sound of those trash cans. Every time I wheel them in, or anybody else in earshot of wheeling the trash cans in or out, she is a nut. She's barking, barking, barking. And, I mean, a couple of my neighbors know that she's going to bark when they take out their trash or bring in the trash cans. She just doesn't like it. It's like, plastic wheels on pavement, how that sounds. I think that the wheels should be redesigned on all of the trash cans to keep the world quieter. I think that we should make an effort to be quieter in the world. You know, less engine noise, rubber on the wheels, like that type of thing. What do you think? Just checked on Amazon. Sharon says, in the pencil sharpener I bought is no longer available. Chris is offering some advice about Cleo, Alice. Chris is saying, if it helps if you say, if you're reassuring things to them, I just keep telling you that I understood and it's going to be okay. Yeah, you got to just talk to them, right? As long as I am there, mine are okay. But if I'm not there, mine go nuts. Oh, with the trash cans? Yeah, isn't it awful? It's crazy. I got to get a message from somebody here. Okay, so one of our, actually, I'm going to be doing this today. Is it is it today I'm doing this? No, I can't say what I'm going to do because I can't do it today. All right, so I'll have to keep everyone in the dark. All right, so we finished this page. Pretty cool, right? Let's see what else we're working on for this book. Where are we at? Where are we at? That's kind of like a Philadelphia thing to say, isn't it? Where are we at? All right, here's this one. Next week, we have a mandala, and the topic is speckling or speckled. And we're going to be using colored pencils, and then we could probably bring in a like a marker or something to add the specks to. So this one, let's pop the dates. There is a color along that I may have to. What's the date on that one? Today is the 6th. Is next week the 12th or the 13th? I think I have the wrong date on this checklist. On this calendar. Yeah, I do. I have the 12th on there. Unless I can't even read it. Who knows? Okay, it's the 13th nonetheless. Then we have a grayscale page coming up on the 20th. Then on the 27th, which is, this is the one that I might have to reschedule. I'll know as we get closer. I'm either going to pre-record it or I'm going to change the time. Something like that. And then we have this one coming up on February 3rd. Then we have this one, which I'm so excited about. This one's going to be a lot of fun. I can't wait. On the 10th, February 10th. And then this is the last one on February 17th. And then we take a little bit of a break. And on March 3rd is when the next book begins. So that's what's happening with Call Along. So that's exciting. Let's see. I have to catch up on my comments. Chris says, maybe she barks because it's hurting her ears. Yeah, I think she just hates, I think she's afraid, actually. I think Scarlet barks at those trash cans because she's petrified. I think a lot of times the Scarlet barks is because she's really afraid. She's a great watchdog, but I think maybe she's just like, I'm trying to keep everybody safe, and I'm trying to watch over my house and my family, but really, I'm scared to death. You know? So I think that's part of her problem. Yeah, you can, sometimes you do have to pay for trash, right? That's how it happens. That's how it goes. So I've got some workshops coming up. I've got a drawing workshop coming up on January 12th. And if you're interested in signing up for that, the sign-up date said January 1st, but you can still do it as long as you can get all the information on time, in time, which is really just a PDF that you would have to print out and whatever supplies you would need. That's happening, starts January 12th. There's a link on my website if you're interested in that. Then I have a needle felting workshop that's coming up on January 14th, 21st, and 28th. It's a three-day workshop. It's on three Fridays in January. So that's going to be fun. If you're interested in signing up for that, there's still time to get into that one also. What else do I have happening? Monday painting continues, and we can continue on if anyone's interested. The replays are always available. We meet on Mondays at 10 a.m. And what else is happening? I have a new book that came out today, actually. It's a new book called Hearts and Flowers that came out today. And, it's 50 pages of, and I'm looking to see if the other one's out yet. 50 pages to color. It's a pocket size coloring book. All of the links are on my, Facebook page and in the Just Color Coloring group over on Facebook. And you can check out all of that. I have another book that's going to be coming out hopefully today, I believe. It looks like it's not out yet, but hopefully it'll be out today. It's called Jazzy Patterns. It's an 8.5 by 11 inch book with 30 pages of some pretty less intricate pages to color. So that one, if you've seen the post for that, that looks exciting, right? That looks like it's a lot of fun. I'm also working on a couple other coloring books. I'm going to be working on a new color by number book. I am working on a dog book that's kind of like a little boxes style. I've been kind of chipping away. And there was another book too, Big Variety Coloring Book Volume 4. That's what I'm working on. I'll be working on that. Big Variety Coloring Book Volume 4. And then I'm not really sure what other time. Oh, I do have my list, but I've got a mandala book that I'll be working on too. I'm going to be working on a hand-drawn mandala book. So I'm chipping away at different books as we move along, and I usually work on a few of them at the same time. But my focus really has been on a lot of different classes and a lot of different workshops. There's a coloring challenge happening this week, and I believe into next week over in the Just Color coloring group. That's all about picking a color every day. So you can take a look at that if you're looking for some sort of challenge. So the other thing that will be happening, and I'm not sure if it's going to happen in January or February, is that I'll be having a live painting sale like I used to do back in the day. Selling some original works. I am also going to be having some different paintings that I am going to be having for sale as prints, and like an 8.5 by 8 by 10 print that you can frame. And I'm also going to be putting together some sort of like remember how I did the coloring bundle that had a lot of Christmas coloring pages in it? I'm going to be putting together something else. It's going to be more of like a craft box, so I'm going to be doing more of those types of bundles that'll be more like kits, whether it'll be like a little craft box or maybe something that will have various different sizes of different prints of paintings that you could frame, kind of like a fungal thing. Donna is asking a really good question. For the drawing class, what kind of paper are you going to use? You probably say in the PDF. Thank you, Bonnie Hughes. It is the 13th, right? Okay, thank you, John. This is a really good sketchbook, actually. This is a small one. So this is the one I just grabbed, but I have all the paper. This is Canson Mixed Media. I love this one. So if you're looking for the type of paper to use for the drawing class, Donna, you could use really any paper that you would like. But I'm going to be using a mixed media type of paper. So and that's usually the best, or maybe like a drawing paper. A lot of people say a preferred, like different papers, they're partial to different papers. I really love this Canson product because I like the tooth of it, and we'll talk about that when we're drawing. And it basically, the tooth is when you can feel it. So this one is an 5.5 by 8.5 book. But I will say, let me see what's in here that I can give you an example of. How the tooth hits. Let me see. There was another one in here. Well, see how that kind of just hits right there? See, I can kind of see the texture on this. So that's an example. This is another example of how that paper works for just kind of a vine charcoal. This was taped in here. What was the other one I wanted to show you? There was something else. What size would you recommend for the drawing paper? I would go with an 8.5 by 11 type thing. Usually a drawing sketchbook is usually not that size. It usually comes in like a 7 by 10 or a 9 by 12. So the Canson one, I believe, by the way, this is why I don't draw people. Scary. I'm going to tell you, this is why I do not draw people. This is my attempt at drawing a person, and this is why I do not. So people have said to me, you should draw something you feel that's out of your comfort zone, and you should draw people, and this is why I do not. All right. No, I don't know where the other one is. Okay. So it usually comes in like a 7 by 10 or a 9 by 12. Let me see. Oh, I have another one too, actually. I'll show you. Another book. This one's a good paper too. This one is from Art. This is an Artist Loft one. And this is a Michaels brand. But again, this paper isn't bad. It's a 70 pound. This one's the Canson is a 60 pound. And it usually kind of tells you like what would be on it. This is a good size paper, actually. This one is 9 by 12. And then the other one that is really surprising to me is this, which I bought at the dollar store. So this one is the sketch pad. It's got 40 sheets in it, standard weight. It says ideal for dry media, which is perfect, right? And I did not know this was made by Ticonderoga, who makes pencils. So this one is a smoother paper. But this sketch pad's got 40 sheets in it, again, 9 by 12. This is from the dollar store. I always buy a whole bunch of these when I see them, just to kind of have them on hand and just kind of stock up on them. This is a paper that has a smooth enough finish to it that sometimes I'll use this to draw a coloring book. So I really like this one. The other one that's really nice, if I can find it, I can't, I haven't found it to purchase any more of them, is one by Dollar General. So if you have a Dollar General, let me see if I can find it. I don't know if I have it. This is another one, a Strathmore one, that's nice, mixed media. This is a small one, Strathmore. I don't know where that other one is, but there is a sketchbook that they sell. I might have boxed it up. I think I did. There's a sketchbook that they sell at Dollar General. It's got a black plastic cover. And I used to just buy them like crazy, and then they stopped carrying them. And then I did a lot of coloring books drawn inside that book. I liked it because it was spiral bound. But then they stopped carrying it, and then Dollar General caught on fire near me. So I haven't been to Dollar General in a very long time, and I miss it. I don't know where there is another Dollar General around here either. Does that answer the question about the size, Sharon? I would go with like that 9x12. Yeah, the 9x12 with Canson is good. The other thing is that I try to not do that 9x12 if I'm going to scan it, because just because the size of my scanner. Alice says, drawing people so hard, I tried once and gave scary new meaning. That's how I feel. All right, so Donna, that's perfect. 7x10 or 9x12 Canson mixed media is perfect. But anything that says mixed media, that's like a, because we're going to be working with charcoal, we're going to be working with graphite, which is pencil. We're going to be working with drawing pencils, so you want to be able to have something that has a little bit of tooth to it or some texture. The other thing that really, believe it or not, is is a pay, and I'm laughing at this, but it, I mean, I guess this because there could be a backstory to this, but anyway, the other paper that is really good is like brown craft paper. Dawn knows about, Dawn says, I only use Canson for my drawings. Yeah, I love a Canson product. That's my favorite. But that Dollar General one, if I could find that again, I gotta look online to see maybe if they have it online anymore. They used to for a while. The other paper that's really nice is that brown craft paper that you could, like, wrap something up in. You know, just, like, regular, like, brown craft paper. Or a paper bag from a store. That paper from a paper bag. Now, when you look at that paper, right? When, I don't have a paper bag to show you, but if you were to tear the piece of paper in half, you could kind of see little pieces of thread, the pulp of the paper. You can kind of see it through there. So that's really a nice paper to draw on. It's really good for charcoal and chalk pastels and that type of thing. Oil pastels work really good on that. The other paper that's really, really good, which I will have some paper that I'm using with that, is this paper that you can buy to cover a flaw when you're working on a project. So it's mostly sold at like a Home Depot or a Lowe's or Sherwin-Williams paint supply paint store has it. It's used, they use it in construction to cover the flaw. I think it's called rosin, and it comes in a few different colors. It comes in either white or brown or this like pinkish color, and it's got a really good tooth for it. It's very thick. A lot of times I use it to cover my desk. Because if you spill something on it, the water doesn't really completely soak through. So that paper, I'll have some of that paper at the drawing workshop that we'll be talking about. And I'll probably have a paper bag too. So we'll talk about different papers, and do some experimenting, but you would be surprised. It doesn't have to always be like what you think you should buy at an art supply store. So, yeah, and you could use, the other thing you could use is cardstock paper, if it's really a thick paper. Do you know that floor paper I'm talking about, Dawn? That, I have a brand new roll of it, actually, and they kind of fell into my hands. So I need to unroll that. Someone gave me a whole roll of it. It's kind of a funny story, but I don't want to talk about it on YouTube. Anyway, thanks for joining me. This was fun. I'll see everyone next Thursday when we start to color the speckled page. And I hope you have a great day and stay safe in the weather. And enjoy your day. Talk to you soon. Thanks so much, everyone.